I'll be in the center. That's the gift of God. The love of God set upon Mount Calvary about 2,000 years ago. And it's hard to explain, but God has a gift for you because He loves you. And that gift is His Son for your eternal life. What must I do to be saved? Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved. And yet, if you reject the gift of God, the gift of God has been proclaimed, has been delivered to all you that have heard my mouth. You have heard the gift of God is Jesus Christ. You have heard about hell. You have heard about heaven. You have heard about death. You have heard about the way. You will stand without excuse upon the judgment, that you'll stand before God one day. Especially all you vendors are here, as we're trying to be here week after week after week, as you hear my big mouth voice. You have heard the gospel over and over and over, and you're going to continue to hear it as long as God's willing, as God is able to provide the time to be here, to hear about the Lord Jesus Christ. And if you continue to reject, for those that have just heard the word for the first time, for those who have rejected or will reject the Lord Jesus Christ, John chapter 3 says there's condemnation. Once you hear about Jesus Christ and reject Him, the love of God is gone. And that's not going to be popular tomorrow morning in your churches across America. Your Church of America tomorrow morning will preach Fruit Loops and sugar-coated messages, which will give its congregation diabetes. As soon as you reject Jesus Christ, the love of God is gone. And John chapter 3 says you fall under the condemnation and the wrath of God. And there's only one hope. Until you take your dying breath. This gift is offered to you as long as you're breathing. It expires the day you die or the night you die. Once you die, you cannot change your location, no matter how many prayers or candles or whatever anybody says. Once you face death, that's it. The choice is now, and I'm here to tell you, people, you're not guaranteed another minute. You're not guaranteed another hour. You're not guaranteed another night. You don't know when death will visit you. The time of salvation is now. To continue to have the love of God in your life is to believe on the Lord Jesus Christ and be saved. Be born again. Come on over. I'll open the Bible and show you what God shows you need to do. I will not turn to traditions. I will not turn to man. I will show you the way of God. Today can be the day that you're saved. Today you can still retain the love of God. But if you continue to refuse the Lord Jesus Christ, Noah and surety, according to the Bible, the love of God is gone out of your life. Now there's mercy and grace if you're still living. The mercy and grace that God shows you because you're still living is the fact is that God's long-suffering. He's not willing that any should perish. God does not want you to go to hell. God does not want you to die without Christ. Why are we here? We're here to proclaim the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ that you need to be saved. You need to be born again. John 3:3. And that whatever you're believing in to get to heaven outside the Lord Jesus Christ, you are wrong. For Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. That's it. If anybody were to ask you how you get into heaven, if it's not Jesus Christ, the shed blood, belief, not eating, not drinking, but belief that Christ has washed you, has cleansed you from your iniquities, your sin. If it's anything but that, the gospel that Jesus Christ died, was buried according to the Scriptures, and arose again the third day, all according to Scriptures. If that is not your way into heaven, you are wrong. And I will not tell you that. When you stand before God, the Lord Jesus Christ, at the great white throne judgment, when He tells you to depart from me, ye workers of iniquity, but Lord, didn't I swallow you every weekend? Lord, didn't I drink your blood? Depart from me, all ye workers of iniquity, I never knew you. But Lord, didn't I sell magazines for this religion? Depart from me, ye workers of iniquity, I never knew you. That is Jesus speaking. But Lord, didn't I give money to all these organizations? Wasn't I a non-profit? Depart from me, all you workers of iniquity, I never knew you. If you don't know Jesus Christ, not only do you not have the love of God, if you don't know Jesus Christ as your Savior, God doesn't know you. So without Jesus Christ, you have no love of God, and God does not know who you are. All the Bible, all the Gospels,